I'm a sailor on a concrete sea. A sailor on a concrete sea.
Yep. Hi. Well, we're out here in Missouri. Commuting on a commuter dash somewhere near St. Joseph, Maryville, on 29 South. Now, what we've got here is limited access carriageway, see? And this is an important thing that's a little bit of history here. Now, this is to the best of my ability. Yes, we had... this was President Eisenhower, I believe. He put in, you know, I remember as a kid when Ike was in office. So we got a merge here. I called it the entrance. It's good to move over for him. Ike had working on the coordination of the war effort before he became president of the United States. Over there, World War II in Europe. And he got to Germany and discovered the Autobahn that Adolf Hitler had developed. Now, the problem with Adolf was he was suffering from extreme insanity. But every now and then, he'd have these bouts of genius. Now, this is a very important thing. And you see, for example, if you look up at the sky, you see patterns of the clouds there? They don't make any sense as far as, well, we see green trees, sky, ground, fields. Okay, that tells a story. But once you get up into, say, the random structure of leaves in those trees, or say the cattle at the cattle feed there, you begin to develop a stimulus for the right hemisphere of the brain, as far as I know. It's like, I took a little visual physiology at Oxford for a while. Professor Wittrich. But anyway, what happens is people have here in the United States, we have become a very literature-minded people. Everything has to tell a story, even the paintings. And of course, Hitler did very kind of storybook-type paintings, I suppose. He was actually an art student, and but however, he did manage to develop a dialogue. This is what we all need between the right and left hemispheres of the brain. Now, this is basic neurology. We really should be learning this kind of thing in high school. Now, you see here, I don't have to. We got these entrants here, so all I have to do is slow down a little bit to make sure that these folks get in. There we go. Everybody's happy. We're all in a dual carriage. Now we gotta. What happened with Hitler was he got the idea for the Autobahn, and then in his insanity, he looked like he was trying to connect Germany with a inexpensive source of gasoline. For a while, they tried to make synthetic gasoline, which didn't work out too well for them in those days. Now we're going 70 miles an hour. Basically, what you need to do is you need to keep on the speed limit because apparently the law assumes that since you have two lanes, you don't need to speed up to pass a car. So this car is going a little less than 70 miles an hour of speed limit. Probably they have their cruise control set at a point they're just going along. My cruise control is gone on this. It's always polite to signal before you turn in. Have a peek at your blind spot. There comes a point, you see the car coming up behind us, where when he gets to my blind spot there, where I'm sitting here, that car will almost go invisible. Right about there. See? I don't want to fluster him. Oh, I still have my, okay, so what happens here is Eisenhower, apparently from what I know, manages to get this pushed through. And when I was a kid in the 50s, I saw this these highways starting to be developed and constructed around us. I remember traveling with Dad, and it would take forever. You'd get behind a truck, and in those days, if the truck had a hill or something, it downshifted so much that, not like the modern trucks, it would go really slow, especially if it had a load. And also, the loads were wrong for like cement mixers and tankers that carried liquids. The modern tankers are now engineered a little bit better. Anyway, so what happens is, as you can see, this limited access carriageway is a dual carriageway. It has two lanes going in each direction. It has there's an overpass, you see. Now it has ramps coming into it. So what happened is, this was developed around the 50s, and you see, Eisenhower developed this extensive highway system, and it really helped the prosperity of the United States. How much? Well, I don't know whether that statistic's available. It can be measured, it can be traced, because we no longer have just a history. We now have a record of current events. Now, there were a couple of things wrong with the way it was set up. They couldn't experiment. And so Eisenhower's adaptation of the Autobahn, Hitler's Autobahn, by the way, interesting, two Germans, Eisenhower and Hitler, well, Hitler was not a German, he was, Viennese. I always have trouble with Vienna for some reason. I was there once, got to see the Blue Danube. I was very disappointed because it was a brown Danube when I saw it. I was looking forward to seeing this gorgeous blue color that they made such gorgeous music about. Da 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 da. Of course, I was this 9-year-old kid, so I would sing along with it, but I'd make up my own, like, words, you know. Oopa gecko, hot cross buns, you know. Anyway. Okay, so, now you see here, you see how you have that connection up there? You have this overpass, and wherever you have this overpass and the connection, you have a business starting up. Now, what you have here is a very primitive, I mean, you gotta remember, it's more healthy to think of ourselves as primitive and not as advanced. We know we've advanced, but lose the attitude. If you know you're primitive, Socrates is trying to point that out to us. If you know you're primitive, you can make progress. You can start stepping out. I see we have a ratio problem. This person's advancing at a ratio of speed, and I'm in front of this truck. So what I have to do is be content with going about 5 miles an hour slower. Then you let them pass. Okay, now, in the areas where there is no overpass, you see, you don't have this connectivity joining to create an economic engine. Now, that affects the prosperity of the collective. It diminishes the prosperity of the collective. But that's not what we're talking about here. What we're talking about is the highway. You know, it's a spewing view. Now, first of all, it's a grid system. Basically, roughly, running at right angles to each other. 29 goes south, Internet 90, and Interstate 90, Interstate 70 go east-west. Now, what you have is when you have a length, for example, east to west, in both the United States and China and Asia, for example, what you really need is, now this is theoretical, you'd have to prove it first, but you need the highway system to go at angles, not at right angles, perpendicular and horizontal, but at, what I suppose, 45 degree angles, at the oblique, you see, crisscrossing. Now, this may also be accomplished by making secondary roads going through these areas. Basically, now you have a problem with maintenance here. As you can see, you have two lanes going in two directions. Now I'm going to speed up here. I have to use my passing gears, man. Use a little gas. You have, now what you really need, you have to have three lanes in each direction. One lane is closed to traffic at all times. And you alternate the lanes. That way you give one of the surfaces a chance to rest. The other thing is you have a chance to do maintenance on the third lane that's closed down each time. It's things like that, ratios. But here we have, this is the big lesson here. You see right here, for example, where that little sign is, 2971, or this one for downtown St. Joseph. Nothing happening here, you see? Well, you say, well, that's farmland. Yeah, okay, yes it is. However, you see, what happens is the limited access highway produces a shadow. For example, on the other side of the Rocky Mountains, the western side, in Arizona suffers from what is called the rain shadow. This is an economic shadow. The limited access carriageway produces an economic shadow for its entire length, except where there is a transverse connection to it. That's very, very important to remember that. So you see, Eisenhower's interstate system exponentially increased the prosperity of the United States. It turned it into a veritable engine, a powerhouse almost, that sort of almost like powered the world economically for a while, maybe still. But you see, it had its drawbacks. The economic shadow also diminished some of that potential. The potential of circulation, the potential of when money changes hands, it increases the value of money. Because there is an important thing of economics. As you see, look at those trees. See the trees there? All along. In each of those trees, there's, for example, you can look there and you can see genetic information and numbers. They're all enumerated. The genes are part of an enumeration of a living organism. Now the human being is, in a primitive way, economically, especially with the advent of computers, is learning how to enumerate things by placing some sort of economic value on it. Now the economic value right now is very primitive because of the intellectual limitations of the human mind for these things. So you have a value assessment that is a mere approximation. It isn't completely accurate as it is in nature. So what we have here is we are learning to assess this value. But we are also learning something about this connectivity, the economic engines. And in this engine, it has a very valuable plus, but it may be like heading in the wrong directions. What you really need is to oblique the lanes. And what that does for you is, as you notice, they're pulling maintenance on here. You see, they put a tar seal on that. And you can also see where the trucks are going. They tend to leave indentations. We're running on grooves here. Hey, this is groovy. Anyway, so you see, so you have a problem with the angularity. If it were at transverse angles, then it would enable the traffic to move from east to west while going north to south. And that would also increase exponentially the prosperity. So if you estimate the prosperity of the United States from the 1950s to the 90s, you could increase that prosperity by about 300%. Now, the next thing is the connectivity. Now, you notice here we have a transverse going to the at a right angle to the carriageway. But there is no indication of economic prosperity there, but you'd have to investigate it. So we have three factors involved here right away. You have the wrong angle, perhaps. The more remarkable increase that is afforded by these carriageways, however, is diminished by, you see, for example, that homestead with something on the other side, with a, you see, there's a secondary road running the length. But now, if you had some kind of connectivity, you probably might have a general store up here on the hilltop. It's hard to say, but anyway. You know, it's like some of these things are for sale, by the way, in case you want a nice house. It's really nice out here. So you have the economic shadow that's caused by the limited access. Now, the other thing is maintenance. Now, you see, you have to shut down lanes and stop traffic for maintenance. But what happens is, if you have a constant two-lane, single-direction, limited access roadway, yet there is a third lane, but a third lane is closed alternately. What you will get is a dramatic increase in prosperity because you can pull maintenance. And it will not diminish the speed of concourse. And also, if they had to do maintenance on this road and created two directions on the other side temporarily using cones and markers, that would immediately stop the access to this side of the highway. For example, this exit coming up. Now that's a sign. Kansas City, 40 miles. You see, if I was over that lane for maintenance on this, it really would be impossible for the workers to create an off-ramp for me from that side of the road, the dual carriage. So, just another interesting thing. You see, you notice the amount of trees here, see? Now in other areas, the trees have been felled or denuded, and the trees increase the natural sequestration of carbon dioxide. The trees actually sequester carbon dioxide, but it can be retrieved if needed. That's another story for another time. Well, I guess we better close this thing. Take care. there. Signing out from Bee Creek out here in I-29 South in Missouri. So long for now.